ओ है वैष्णव ठाकुर दयार सागर वेदसे करुणा कोरी। ओ है वैष्णव ठाकुर दयार सागर वेदसे करुणा कोरी। निया चर छाया शोधो हे आमाया तुम्हार चरण दोरी। या पद छाया शोधो हे आमाया तुम्हार चरण दोरी। छाया वेग धोवी छाया दोष शोधे छाया गुण देहो दासे। छाया दोष शोधे छाया गुण देहो दासे। छाया सत्संग देहो है आमारे पोषे छे संगे राखे। छाया सत्संग देहो है नहीं पाया बाला परिणाम संकीर्तने। एकाके अमार नहीं पाया बाला परिणाम संकीर्तने। तुमी कृपा कोरी श्रद्धा बिंदु दिया देह कृष्ण नाम धने। कृपा कोरी श्रद्धा बिंदु दिया देह कृष्ण नाम धने। एकाकी अमार नहीं पाया बल हरि नाम संकीर्तने। एकाकिया मार नहीं पाया बल हरि नाम संकीर्तने। तुम्हें कृपा कोरी श्रद्धा बिंदु दिया देह कृष्ण नाम धने। कोरी श्रद्धा बिंदु दिया देह कृष्ण नाम। कृष्ण से तुमार कृष्ण दीते पार तुमार शकतिया छे। कृष्ण से तुमार कृष्ण दीते पार तुमार शकतिया छे। हमें तो कंगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण बोले भाईताव पाथे पाथे। हमें तो कंगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण बोले भाईताव। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे। हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे। हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे। हरे राम वैष्णव ठाकुर जय वैष्णव ठाकुर आचार्य ठाकुर जय आचार्य ठाकुर वैष्णव ठाकुर हरे कृष्ण महामंत्र की अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की श्रील प्रभुपाद की हरनाम प्रभु की ओम अज्ञान तमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवम् श्रीराधा कृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पामनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्णचैतन्यप्रभुनित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैतगदाधर श्रीवासादिगौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं मुदीरये नष्टप्रायेष्वभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवत्युत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नन्दनाय च नन्दगोपकुमाराय गोविन्दाय नमो नमः हरे कृष्ण वेरी हैप्पी टू बी विथ ऑल ऑफ यू इन सिंगापुर टुडे डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ग्लोरीज ऑफ द होली नेम एंड यू ऑल हैव बीन हियरिंग एवरी डे डिफरेंट मेनी एग्जॉल्टेड स्पीकर्स हैव बीन कमिंग I am like an odd man out in the list of the speakers. Nevertheless, owing to my friendship with His Grace Devakinandan Prabhu and Dhinavan Chaitanya Prabhu and other devotees there, I think they have invited me to share something. So what is my enthusiasm in coming today and addressing all of you? If I please you, then you all will bless me that I'll be able to chant the holy names offenselessly, purely, helplessly, in a mood of surrender. So with that greed, I'm here with all of you today. So I had given the topic, how to be grateful, patient, focused and absorbed. So four things about the holy name. Actually, when we read the glories of the holy name, it becomes easily understandable how merciful the Lord's holy name is. It becomes very, very clear. There are innumerable shlokas. I am only going to quote three or four of them, just to make our beginning today. Naam no hiyavati shakti papam nirharane harehe tavat kartum nashaknoti patakam pataki naraha. In this world, there are various degrees of sinful activities. There is a pap, there is mahapap, there is pataka, mahapatak. There are different deeper and deeper degrees of sin. And accordingly, the results also come for our sinful activities. For example, if somebody did some small amount of sin, you know, he may be running on the road and he may fall on the ground and get a wound in the knee. If he did even more greater, deeper a type of sin, he may be crossing the road and some car or bus may hit him and then he may fracture his leg. Fracturing leg is more serious than getting wound in the leg, isn't it? Or if somebody has done terrible sin like killing a cow and aborting a child and all that, then he may be crossing the road and running, he may be hit by some vehicle and he may die on the spot. That is even more serious. So in this way, different type of sins bring different results also. And they have to be done, they have to be nullified also with greater amount of pious activities. For example, gurunam cha lagunam cha gurunicha lagunicha prayaschittani papanam yatvottani maharshibhi. It is said that for small sin there are small punishments, for bigger sin there are bigger punishments. But here is one good news. Namno hi yavati shakti papam nirharane hare. If somebody is taking shelter of Krishna's holy names, the holy names are able to eradicate that much quantity of sinful reactions which one is unable to commit, it is said. Like, you know, if somebody passes urine on the side of the road, the sun evaporates it. See, sun is so powerful, it can evaporate all the urine and all over the surface of the globe, still not get contaminated. The sun can remain as pure as it has been always. At the same time, it cleanses the place where the urine was passed. So we can say like this, nobody can pass so much urine that sun cannot evaporate. So in the same manner, nobody can commit sin that holy name cannot dry up. That's the power of the holy name. Can you imagine? And what is the proof for this? One terribly sinful person, Ajamila, who had, you know, driven away his chaste wife, driven away his old parents, aged parents, pious parents. And he wanted to bring the prostitute to his home and enjoy with her and beget 10 children in her womb. What a terrible sin. Think about it. And he just called out one name. Narayana! And then he called up one name. Immediately Lord Vishnu in the spiritual world, Vaikuntha, took notice of that. And told the Vishnudas, go instantly. Some devotee is calling my name. Vishnudas told the Lord, my Lord, that's not your devotee. He is actually a very terrible sinful person. He is not calling you, my Lord. He is calling his own son. But Lord Narayana said, better you give him a benefit of doubt. Better you go and find out. Anyway, even if he called his son, but he has addressed my name, definitely you should go there. Lord immediately sent them there. Mriyamana harer nama grinan putro pacharitam ajamilopyagadhama kim uta shraddaya grinan. See this beautiful verse. Mriyamana harer nama. Mriyamana means at the time of death, mrityu. Mriyamana harer nama. He just called out Narayana's name only once at the time of death. Grinan putra upacharitam. He addressed the name to his son, putra, he says. But ajamilopi agadhama. And then subsequently he got a chance to get purified. And then the next 12 years he practiced bhakti yoga seriously. Agadhama, he went back to Vaikuntha. Kim uta shraddaya grinan. What to speak of somebody who is calling the Lord's name with great transcendental faith. So you can see the nature of the holy name, how the holy name is merciful, simply by calling the holy name indirectly. Not addressing the holy name directly, but addressing it indirectly, calling his son. Still the holy name is so merciful. It's appearing and it's showering its mercy upon even the greatest of the sinners. So this reminds me of one thing that happened in Pune. I was in the Brahmacharya Ashram in the last room. One of the days, many, many years ago, I got a phone call from somebody. Somebody asked me, you know, is there somebody called Santosh in your ashram? I said, there is nobody like that, that name. So he said, sorry, I'm sorry, it's a wrong number, he said, and he was about to keep it down. I said, wait a minute, it's not wrong number, it is God's number. I said, he said, really? Is it God's number? I said, yes, it is Radha Kunjibehari temple and it is Srila Prabhupada's ISKCON temple in Pune. And I said, if you have little time, I can tell you a little bit about ISKCON Pune and Prabhupada. He said, yes, I have time. So I spoke to him 5 minutes. I told him about Krishna, I told him about Prabhupada, I told him about Prabhupada going to America and preaching and distributing the holy name. At the end, I told him the Mahamantra and told him can you please chant this mantra every day, one round? He immediately agreed. Then I called him, can you come on Sunday to our temple? Immediately agreed. And he asked him, should I come alone or should I bring my whole family? I said, bring the whole family. So subsequent Sunday, he brought his wife and children and mother, father, everybody came to the temple. And that was it. And then I totally forgot, you see. Almost 5-6 years later, that same person, on the day of initiation from his guru, he came and offered obeisances to me with tears in his eyes. I asked, what is the matter? Who are you? He said, you may not remember, you are president, you are too busy with your things. But he said, let me tell you the true story. He said, 5 years ago, I had made a call to your temple number because one digit was wrong. Therefore, I happened to call. I was calling my friend somewhere else and one digit was wrong. So it happened to come and, you know, get connected to the temple. He said, at the time, I told you it's wrong number, I told you, but you said it's God's number. And then you connected me to this temple and started coming. And then he said, how merciful the Lord is. Although I called the wrong number, you know, because he saw some little inclination in me, I was searching for the truth in my life. And Lord Radha Kunjibari, you know, he snatched me and pulled me towards themselves along with my whole family. Now we all are initiated devotees and, you know, the holy name is so powerful. You can see that just one wrong phone call I made. Ajamil also made a wrong phone call. He called Narayana not to actual Narayana. He called Narayana to his son. Still Narayana took it seriously. Similarly, this fellow called the wrong number. Still the Lord took him seriously. Your number may be wrong number, but you actually, you didn't intend to call the Lord. You just like that call. Still the Lord took it seriously. That is his kindness. So he said, today I'm initiated now. God has accepted me, you know, through his devotees. So he was saying, I was so happy to hear that. Therefore, he's saying, Kim Uta Shraddha Agrinan. With great Shraddha, if we chant, how much more the holy name will, you know, will be merciful to us. We should think about it. So that's why the very first thing I have said, how to be grateful in spiritual life, to the degree we are grateful, we have a golden heart. And then with that golden heart, we can gradually awaken spiritual feelings. But if you are not grateful, it is said we are a great fool, it is said. Why? Because we are blind to the gifts that we are receiving from Krishna and devotees from all around. For example, if you think about what all Krishna is sending us. Krishna has given us these contemples. He has given so many divyadesams, that are holy tirthas. Isn't it? He has come from holy rivers like Ganga, Yamuna, Kaveri and many other rivers. He has also come as holy books like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam and other books. He has come as holy acharyas like Srila Prabhupada and our spiritual masters. Isn't it? He has come as the holy Sri Vigraha in the temples. He has come as holy prasadam. He has come as a holy name. He's come in varieties of forms like this. Because all of us may not like all these manifestations of the Lord. The most appreciated manifestation you all know is the prasadam. Everybody likes. After that, the devotional music people like. And then slowly they may come to hear the lectures also. So you can see how Krishna is enveloping us from all directions with his mercy. And therefore we have to be grateful to him. And we have to gratefully thank him also. Like Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the second verse of Shikshashtaka, what he says. Naam namakari bahudha nija sarva shaktis tatrarpitaniya mita smarane nakalaha yetadrishi tavagrupa bhagavan mamapi durdaiva midrisha miha janina anuragaha. He's telling, my dear Lord, you have given so many names like Krishna, Govinda, Gopal, Madhava, Madhusudana. So many names. And each of these names is spiritually very, very potent. Anybody who calls these names are so powerful, they can deliver a person very quickly. This reminds me of a story from Narasimha Purana. In Narasimha Purana, it talks of a young man who was actually having a bouquet of flowers, which he was carrying to give it to his girlfriend. And suddenly, all of a sudden, there was a flood in that village. There used to be a river, but the river started overflowing now. Now all the people are running hither and thither, helter skelter. So when this river level started increasing, this man also tried to escape. But it was not possible for him because the level was raising up to his leg and then hip and then chest. So he was holding the flower like this. He understood now I think most people are getting drowned and dying. I also don't know swimming. Anyway, I'm going to be dead. What to do with this flower bunch? He thought like that. And then he said, okay, anyway, I'm going to leave the body now. Do something good and leave. He said, Om Govindaya Namah. He said, and then he left the flower and then he got drowned and died. And when Yamadutas came, they got confused. How, whether to take him to Yamaloka or what to do? He just now said, Govindaya Namah. Immediately they retracted back and they went and told Yamaraj, sir, he said, Govindaya Namah is saying, what should we do? Yamaraj said, don't go near. I have told you, don't go near Vaishnavas. Already we have one bitter experience with Ajamila dealing with this case. Huh? So move aside. So they all moved aside. Yamaraj came in the front. And the soul of the man, when it came out, Yamaraj said, you see, man, you have committed terrible sinful activities all your life. Therefore, you deserve to go to hell for a prolonged period of time. And we will tell you how long it is later. But one good thing you did, you told Govindaya Namaha and offered that. So you have 5 minutes of Swargavas. So which one you prefer first? Swargavas or Narakavas? He said, oh, first Swargavas. Let me see the beauty of the Swarga. After that, anyway, I have to spend a long time in Naraka. I can always come, he said. So they took him to Swarga. So when he went to the heavenly planet, he was amazed. There were beautiful mountainscapes and there were beautiful waterfalls. There were beautiful lakes and beautiful gardens filled with fragrant flowers. There were lakes and ponds where the ducks and swans were swimming and the lotuses and lilies. And there were apsaras dancing and other apsaras were playing veena. And there was Indra also. He saw all that. So this man was wondering how beautiful this place is. Just because I did some one small act in my life, rest of my life is all full of sin. So he was thinking like that. But then one thought came in his mind. Time is going to run out now. What am I supposed to do here in the heaven? I am just allowed to witness these things. That's all. I can't enter the heaven and enjoy. From the frontiers, I am allowed to witness these things. So he thought, what good did I do before? I chanted Govinda's name. And here I find so many fragrant flowers in the garden. Let me offer these also to Govinda. Probably something good will happen to me. So immediately he took the scissor and then he started, he used to trim every day in his garden. Similarly, now he was trimming all the flowers and picking up an offering. Govinda Anama, Keshava Anama, Narayana Anama, Madhusudana Anama, Trivikrama Anama. Like that he was telling names of the Lord and throwing the flowers up in the air. Fervently with devotion, closing his eyes, he was offering like that. And guess what happened? What is because 5 minutes? It became half an hour. Continuously he was offering. And nobody came. He thought, Yamaraj has probably forgotten me. He thought, at the time, one beautiful demigod came with a mukut and kundal and then gave a chit to him, in which it was written, dear man, you were sent to heaven for just 5 minutes, but that 5 minutes you utilized it so well in uttering Lord's so many names and offering him flowers in Archana. Therefore, your Narakavas is cancelled. Your stay in Naraka is cancelled. And now you are allowed to continue to stay in heaven for a long, long time. And if you become a strictly practicing devotee, seriously practicing devotee, then you will go back home, back to Godhead from there. Your servant, Yamaraj, like it was written. So man became very joyful. So again, this is the point. Just see, first one name he chanted, inspired by that one name. Now he chanted many, many more names in the heaven. And then he eventually got a way to go back home, back to Godhead. Similarly, when you all met the devotees, they must have asked you to chant one round. Now you all, many of you are chanting 16 rounds now. And you are inspired like that. And now your good account, spiritual account is also going on increasing. Golden account is increasing now. You see, this is how the spiritual life begins. So the holy name also gives us the inspiration to chant more eventually as we get purified more. And then we can approach Krishna's lotus feet more and more easily. So therefore, holy name is a very, very merciful form of the Lord, which comes. Actually, why the holy name is so glorified? Because Krishna and the holy name are non-different, which you all have heard. Why it is called non-different? The reason is explained by Haridas Thakur to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he asked him this question. Why the holy name and Krishna are abhinnatvam nama namino, it is said. So Haridas Thakur explains this. He says, Krishna's name, form, qualities, pastimes and activities are all matching together. You just say Krishna, everything is there in that one word Krishna. Which means, for example, in this world you see somebody is very handsome looking, but their qualities are not good. They are very arrogant and proud. And somebody is a very humble person, very good person, but his form is not very beautiful. You find like that. Sometimes you find somebody is very good looking, but he's a muff. He has no intelligence at all. Even he opens his mouth, everybody knows, so he's a muff, he doesn't know anything. But on the other hand, somebody may, like in my class, there used to be a short and very stocky boy. His hair would always stand like this. When you comb like this, again it will come back like this. So that fellow, he was a topper in the class. We two, three of us used to have competition in our study. So he was a topper. And he would have a lot of pimples on his face. He was looking very ordinary. But he was very intelligent. In this world, in this way, there is a mismatch between the qualities and the beauty and all these things in this world. They are not one. Whereas in Krishna's case, all are one. That means in this world, somebody is called Lakshmipati, but he may be a beggar. Somebody is called Padmalochan, but he may be a blind man. He doesn't have a lotus petal-like eyes, rather he's a blind man. On the other hand, in spiritual world, when you say Krishna is Sundara Gopal, he's actually Sundar. When you call him Lakshmipati, he's actually Lakshmipati. Yeah. When you say Padmalochan, yes, he has Kamala Nayanam. So whatever you say, glorify him, that matches with his name. Therefore, Nabhinnatvam Nama Namino, it is said. The name and Krishna are not different. Okay, they are not different, but there is one very important difference. What is it? The holy name and Krishna are one, but holy name is more merciful than Krishna, it is said. Why? Because holy name bestows Krishna. Taramadhya sarva sreshta nama sankirtan nirparada namalole pave premadan. He is saying, if you chant offenselessly, the holy name can give us premadan. So, it is a bhajane ramadhya sreshta navavidha bhakti krishna prema krishna dite dhare mahashakti. He says that amongst the all type of bhajans, navavidha bhakti is best. And in navavidha bhakti, chanting of the holy name is best, he says. And by chanting of the holy name, it can give you Krishna and Krishna prema. These two can be given by the holy name, he says. So, because the holy name is bringing us to Krishna, actually there is a long list of 25 items given what the holy name gives. And first, the holy name cleanses the sinful reactions. Then the holy name stops our sinful activities in our body. Then the holy name, you know, fries all the sinful seeds. Then the holy name also, you know, completely smashes the sinful proclivities or propensities. Then the holy name eradicates ignorance. When ignorance is eradicated, avidya is eradicated, then a person does not commit sinful activities at all. And then the holy name completely stops the cycle of birth and death. And the holy name inspires a person to develop attraction for Krishna. And when one continues chanting the holy name, one surpasses the punya and papa of this material world. And one gets liberated from the material existence. Not only that, the holy name brings a person from the material world to the spiritual world. And in the spiritual world, the holy name brings a person close to Krishna's lotus feet. And when a person reaches Krishna's lotus feet, the holy name reveals him his own swarupa. The person suddenly sees, oh, my body has become completely spiritual. Earlier I had a sadhana deha, now I have siddha deha. One realizes that I have a transcendental body now. So he sees his spiritual body, he sees Krishna's spiritual body. And then the holy name awakens the pure love for Krishna, bhava and prema. The person has tears welling up in his eyes, hair standing on end, body trembling. All this is brought about by the holy name, the Ashta Sattvika Vikar. And then in this way, the holy name keeps the jiva permanently in Krishna's shelter, watching all the beautiful Nitya and participating in it. In this way, the holy name bestows dozens of benefits, we can say. So therefore, we have to be grateful for having received it from the spiritual master. One should not take it lightly. So, yeah, actually, I am going to give you an extreme example of gratitude, which is Yudhishthira Maharaj feeling gratitude for Dhritarashtra. One time I was speaking to a group of youth. I told them that one morning when Yudhishthira Maharaj got up and took his bath and then came to the court and gave away cows in charity and to the Brahmins and everybody. Then he was searching, uncle, where is my uncle? And where is my aunt? His uncle and aunt were missing, Dhritarashtra and Gandhari. And Vidura was also missing, uncle also missing. So he asked all the servants, he went and asked Sanjaya, hey Sanjaya, you are the secretary? You must be aware, Dhritarashtra, you told him the whole Bhagavad Gita, narrated him. Where is Dhritarashtra. Sanjaya loudly cried. He said, Mushi Tosmi. He said, my master has cheated me by suddenly disappearing from this place. I don't know where he has gone. All three of them are missing. He cried. So that time, Vishnu Maharaj started crying. Your uncle, you know, you were always morose that your 100 sons were destroyed in the battle, including Duryodhana. And I am actually the person who killed all of them with my army. And therefore, you must be feeling great pain in your heart. I think probably you must have jumped into the river and committed suicide or something. Where are you? If you have left the home and you are going to forest, where will you stay in the forest? What food will you eat? You know, who will take care of you? And he said, when we all from the forest came as fatherless children, we Pandavas, it was you who very nicely nurtured us, nourished us, took care of us in the palace, just like you took care of your sons, Duryodhana and company. Like that, he said, is it really true? And did Dhritarashtra take care of Pandavas the way he cared for Duryodhana and company? But that's what Yudhishthira Maharaj was feeling, gratitude for Dhritarashtra. Oh, uncle, you took care of us when we were small, fatherless children. That was his feeling. So I asked the students, imagine if you were in Yudhishthira Maharaj's position, and if suddenly you find Dhritarashtra is missing, what will you do? I asked. So some students were saying, oh, I'll be most happy. Because he was a cunning fellow, diplomatic fellow. He allowed Duryodhana to hatch many plots to kill. He said, we will be most happy, they said. So that's what ordinary people feel. Why I'm telling you this extreme example? By cultivating gratitude like the way Yudhishthira Maharaj, if Yudhishthira Maharaj has gratitude for Dhritarashtra, to who else will he not have gratitude? Similarly, devotees, in our lives also, we should be grateful not only to Prabhupada or our own spiritual master, we should be grateful to all the devotees. All ISKCON devotees, they're all showing a shining example for us. And by their own lifestyle and practice and determination and for so many long years, many people. So, and not only that, we can be grateful for anybody who even in a small way are instrumental in bringing us closer to Krishna. So, Kunti Maharani is grateful to Krishna for saving her children from all the dangerous encounters. Kunti Maharani is grateful to Krishna for his glance at the nature and producing all the greenery and, you know, the blooming flowers and the ripened fruits and, you know, the rivers full of water, the cow's udders full of milk, and the ocean with Navaratnas and the mountains with gold, silver and diamond and minerals like this. So in this way, she is actually grateful to him for providing everything for all the jivas in this world. So we can be grateful for so many reasons. Actually, why I am talking about this gratefulness for so long, because when our heart is grateful, then the chanting quality will be very much improved. Because while chanting the holy name, grateful thoughts will arise in our mind. Oh Lord, we are so thankful to you. You know, you saved me from this dangerous samsara by putting me in the middle of devotees. You know, Parishit is asking for sangha of devotees. Dhruva Maharaj is asking for association of devotees. But you already given me that benediction which they are asking for. I am so grateful to you. So in this way, Prahlad Maharaj showed gratitude to his spiritual master. Evam janam nipatitam prabhavahi kupe kama abhikama manuya prapatan prasangat kritpatma satsura rishina bhagavan grihita sokam katam visrujeta vabritya sevam. He is telling that, my dear Lord, who else, what other benediction I can ask you other than serving my spiritual master who picked me up from the pit that was full of snakes and scorpions, that kind of bad association in which I was living, born in Asuric family. But he picked me up from this family and taught me Krishna consciousness, made me just as good as himself by purifying me. I'm eternally grateful to him. You know, when I look at you, O Lord Narasimha, I'm simply, my heart is welling up with gratitude for my guru. Because if it was not for his training that he offered me, I won't be seeing you eye to eye today, like that he said. So let us learn gratitude from all these great souls in the Srimad Bhagavatam. That was about gratitude. And in the same manner for the holy name also. when we are picking up the bead bag, we should think, oh, this is Chintamani Naam. You know, the holy name is a divine name has been gifted to me by my spiritual master. And I am allowed to chant this holy name. I get to chant every day. I am fortunate to chant, having this gift. because this is such a powerful gift. If I chant nicely, all my greed will go away. All my anarthas will go away. My heart will become decorated with love for Krishna. So we should gratefully accept it. And the second thing is about patience. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, there are three examples for patience. One example is given. If somebody, you want a mango to eat, somebody gives you a mango seed, what you have to do? You have to till the ground, sow the seed, you know, give some water, and then put a fence around the sapling which comes out. Then you have to give some sunlight, be very patient. The plant will grow into a tree, the tree will produce some mango flowers, mango flowers will produce some mango buds, and then a green mango will come, and then ripe mango will come, isn't it? So it requires patience, isn't it, for eating a mango from the mango seed. Similarly, another example is given in Srimad Bhagavatam is the example of milk. You know, now you want to drink milk and somebody gives you a small calf. What will you do with the calf? How can you drink milk? Calf doesn't give you milk. But wait for some time. The calf will grow into a cow and the cow will beget a calf. And then the cow will be able to give milk at that time. And then when you are milking the cow, cow will give you some kicks also. Then you'll have to tie the legs with a rope. And then when you take the milk, then you boil the milk, offer it to Krishna, put some sugar, and then offer it to Krishna. And then only you can drink milk. It takes time, all these things. So this is why the milk example is given also. In the same manner, another example is given. If you want to cook something, you naturally need a firewood. Then you have to go to the forest, you have to break some branches of a tree, cut it into small pieces and put it in a furnace. And when you lit up the fire, immediately fire won't come. It is going to take some time. Sometimes even smoke comes in the beginning. Gradually the fire will increase. And then you can cook your, you know, vegetables or, you know, rice or whatever, isn't it? So I told you three examples for patience. So, in the Bhagavatam, it is said, in the same manner, when you chant the holy name, don't expect a quick heart transformation to happen. Some people expect that my heart should become soft like butter, and tears should come in my eyes, and everything they expect to happen instantly. That won't happen. Because just like firewood is very big firewood, if you are taking a spark of fire and putting, how it will glow immediately? It's going to take some time. Some people actually put the fire below the firewood and they keep on, you know, fanning like this. Gradually the fire picks up, just like when they do yagna and all, you must have seen. When they put a lot of samitsik, smoke comes in the top. Then they fan it like this. Slowly the fire picks up. In chanting also, I have a personal experience. When I chant the holy name, the first 2-3 rounds, so slowly I have to withdraw the mind from outside world into, you know, hearing the holy name with the focus. It takes some time. But once the chanting picks up, then when you come to 6th round, 7th round, 8th round, it's very, very relishable. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, we can be fully into it. So just like, you know, the furnace, you know, the flames start coming up after that. So we need patience, surely. In Ramayana, there is a beautiful example of patience. You know, there is an eagle called Sampati, who is the brother of Jatayu. One time Sampati was telling all the Vanaras, that long before, you know, me and my brother, we were flying up in the sky. And we went so up in the sky, the sun was too hot. And my brother's wings started, you know, burning. I wanted to protect him. So I went above him and gave shade to my brother, eagle. So thus he was saved. But my wings got burned. And I fell from the top down. So I came gliding down. And because of that, after I lost my wings, I am living in this locality. I was thinking, what's the use of my life? A eagle without wings? I can't fly up. What will I do? And then there was one Nishakara Muni who lived in that locality. He came and blessed me and said, don't worry, every day you'll get something to eat. Don't worry. And then 8,000 years from now, he said, you know, you will come across some vanaras, some monkeys, and you will give them some very vital information about the goddess of fortune, Lakshmiji. So when you give that information, your wings will grow that time. So he was thankful to the sage, and the sage went away from that place. Years passed by, hundreds of years passed by. So this poor Sampati was waiting. After when 8,000 years crossed, when these monkeys came, they were inquiring about Sita. That time this bird said, you see, If I had a wing, I would have carried all of you to Lanka, which I see from here. I have a telescopic eyes. I can see Ravana's golden kingdom is there. In that place only he has taken Sita. And the bird said, see, if I had wings, I would have served you. Because I don't have the wings now, I can serve you with my speech by giving you information about Sita. How intelligent he is, you see. So he gave, that means whatever we all have, we should serve Krishna with that. So as soon as he told that new good news to them, they were all grateful to Sampati. At the time, the wings grew. So 8,000 years he waited patiently. Similarly, if you hear about the Matanga Rishi's famous disciple, Shabari. When she was an 8-year-old girl, she became his disciple. She was a little child. And the Guru taught everything to her in bhakti. And then he told her, definitely you will get the darshan of Lord, Supreme Lord one day. And then the sage later on grew up and he left for the spiritual abode. And then this Shabari waited and waited and waited. When she crossed 90 years, at that time, Lord Ram and Lakshman came to that place where she was living to give his darshan. The Lord came. So you can imagine how much patience she had. In the Bhagavatam also, there is one verse where Lord Vishnu himself tells the Dasi Putra who performed the meditation in the forest. First Lord gave him darshan, a glimpse of his beautiful form of, 400 form of Vishnu. Shankar, Chakra, Gada, Padma, Mukut, Kundal, everything. Pitambar, and he was dazzling, shining beautifully. And the boy was thrilled, but it was only a momentary thrill. Lord vanished immediately. And the boy again sat in meditation, tried to see that form again repeatedly. But Prabhupada says mechanical chanting will not help in seeing the Lord. He couldn't see. Boy started weeping. Then Lord spoke in Akashvani, without showing his form. Hanta asmin janmani bhavan mamam drakshamiharhasi avipakpakashayanam durdarshoham kuyoginam. The Lord told him, my dear boy, in this particular lifetime, you will not see me again. And why? Two reasons Lord told him. One reason told him, avipakvakshayana, those people who are not completely pure at heart cannot see me. And those whose services are not complete, they cannot see me. Because service also purifies. So, avipakvakshayana, durdarshoham kuyoginam. He said, kuyogi means one who has not perfected his services. Avipakvakshayana means those whose heart is not yet clean. So when you hear this verse, it appears that boy was unclean in his heart, isn't it? That's not true. Because Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says, the boy was already in bhava stage. He was actually able to see Lord eye to eye. Therefore, there was no impurity in his heart. Then why did the Lord say like that? He says the Lord wanted to make him humble. That was one reason. When he heard Lord say that whose heart is not pure, I will not give darshan, the boy immediately thought, my heart is not pure. I am a fallen soul, like that he thought. And then you may ask, should Lord tell a lie to the boy? It's not a lie, because the Lord saw that the boy has prema for me, but it is only infant prema. He wanted to transform it into adult prema. How do you turn infant prema to adult prema? By cultivating feelings of longing for separation from the Lord. And the Lord gave him that separation by not giving his darshan. He gave a glimpse of darshan and then vanished. It is like somebody gave you 5 crore rupees in the hand and took it away. It's like that. So Lord actually, by giving him that feeling of separation, Lord increased his fondness. Like we say, absence makes the heart grow fonder. That's what the Lord did. So in this way, the boy was perfect already, but the Lord increased his love for him. And then the boy went to all the holy places like Haridwar, Rishikesh, Vrindavan, Mathura, Dwaraka, heard the pastimes of the Lord, took darshan of the Sri Vigrahas, took the holy deep in all the rivers, met saintly people, increased his devotion service, which means he was patient for his whole life. At the time of death, when he left the body, instantly got Narada's body. Devadattam yamam veenam sara brahma vibhushitam murchayitva harikatam gayamanas charamyaham. He's saying, but the Supreme Lord Vishnu at that time called me when I became Narada. He gave me his own veena and he taught me the Sarigama Padanisam. And he blessed me. Now, Narada, you can go all over the universe or even beyond the universe to Vaikuntha also. You can go and you can propagate the glories of the Lord. So, he was given that blessing. So, see the patience of the boy. Whole life he was patient. Similarly, all of us in our chanting also, when we sit for chanting, we should make up our mind that I'm not just going to get up for the next 16 rounds or next couple of hours. Ekadashi days also. One can just peacefully sit and preach to the mind. My dear mind, don't be too eager to finish off the round. It's your duty to listen to every sound vibration, every word. So we can make the mind patient. And regarding the focus, you see, getting focus, just like a magnifying glass, if you have, you have to bring it to the focal point to burn a paper or cotton. Similarly, the chanting of the holy name also, when we hear the sound well, that is the time the impurities in the heart are cleansed by the super soul. When you are hearing. When you are not hearing, when we allow the mind to wander, especially two senses, eyes and ears, when they wander, like, hear some sound or see some sight, this is how we get distracted. That's like Madhumangal once saw another covered boy was having many laddus in his plate. He wanted them. So what he did, he shouted to all the covered boys, "Hey boys, look at the garden. The monkey is hanging upside down. Ha 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 ha." He laughed like that. And all the boys looked into the window. "Ah yeah, that's true. He's hanging upside down," they all said. Meantime, the boy looked at his plate. The laddus were gone because the Madhumangal had sacked them. So you can see this is how the advertisements also distract us. Like you are in the railway station or somewhere. Washing powder, Nirma, you hear some song. As soon as you heard the sound, you look in that direction immediately. And then you see the sight, you see the sound. And then you turn around, your luggage is gone. Somebody has stolen. So you'll find this way our sight and sound are the two powerful distractors. So if you want focus, we have to ensure that we sit in a calm place where there is no sound. And also sight also. If I'm sitting near the door of the temple, all people are coming and going out. Is it a good place? It's a very distracted place. So find out a sacred space where you can avoid these two distractions. Sight and sound, we can avoid. And then not only that, focus means what? Withdraw the mind from external stimuli, external objects and all. And then focus it on hearing the sound vibration of the holy name. And again, don't let the mind wander outwardly. Hold the mind, holding the mind. That is actually called dharana. Dharana means to hold the mind and hearing the holy name. Agasura was holding Krishna in his mouth. So his mouth got purified. And he got Swarupya Siddhi in the spiritual world. If we hold the holy name in our mouth also, chant the holy name and with attention, we will get immense benefit. Kaliya allowed the Lord to dance on his head, and he got purified. My spiritual master once said, all our tongues are like Kaliya, he said. It's like a serpent. And then he chanted, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So Krishna is dancing in our tongue, he said. And how many of you find it difficult? He asked us. So you're all raising a hand. So, and then he said, that means this Kaliya snake is having a lot of poison inside the heart. So he said, when the poison is gone, then you will pick up Krishna and make him dance on your head very happily. But now the poison is not gone. Poison is there. So we feel very great pain. Like Kaliya felt pain like that. So he was telling, let Krishna dance in our tank. Because when Kaliya, on the head of Kaliya, the more Krishna danced, the poison was removed and removed and removed. So he was telling us, let Krishna dance. Don't stop chanting. Continue chanting. One day we were way back in 1992, I think. We were in Chaupati Temple. It was 94, I think. 94 beginning. So I was in Chaupati Temple. There was a Brahmachari there. The early morning, suddenly we saw the cots were vibrating like this. Very, very fastly vibrating. We were actually thrown off from the cot. It was actually like a vibration on the earth's crust, like a bhukamp. So immediately the whole ashram, everybody got up. It was very early in the morning, 3 o'clock. And there was a loud shout of the holy name, Hare Krishna, everybody, because people thought bhukampa means what? What we had heard about earthquake means the bhumi will open like this and you will go inside and the bhumi will close. That's what we had heard about the earthquake. So we thought very soon somewhere it's going to open now. We all are going to inside, we thought. And we must have chanted probably 24 times Arakshana loudly. And then the tremor, the vibration gradually reduced. And the vibration stopped. And after that, everybody gathered and they were talking about it. Then it was already Shankh was blowing in the temple hall. We quickly ran and took a bath and came to temple hall. On that day, my spiritual master was giving Bhagavatam classes. And Ranath Maharaj, he said, at the end of the class, he said, today early morning when I heard the loud chanting of the holy name by all of you in the ashrama, I felt, may this earthquake go on and on forever. you are selling. Because if the earthquake continues, you guys will keep chanting helplessly. You are selling. That's the point. So, in this way, actually, we will not get distracted, especially when we are subject to a traumatic situation like that. But other times, we get distracted with the eyes and ears. So, one has to safeguard one's eyes and ears by choosing a sacred space. It can be a puja room in your house, or it can be one corner place in a temple where nobody will distract you. And try to focus and try to hear. So, initially, there is a distracted zone, which is black frame, black color band, we call it in circles. And inside that, there is a, you know, yellow band. What is that? It is a, actually, there is a distraction, distracted zone, negative distraction zone. All kama, krodha, the lobe, everything comes. Then when you go inside, then there are positive distractions. You think about your sevas, think about service to Lord and all that. And then when you go inside, then there's a circle of prayerful attitude. So I told you about the gratitude, attitude of gratitude. If you have, then all the prayers of Srimad Bhagavatam will become very meaningful for us. And we will memorize the verses and keep reciting them, remembering them. And we will prayerfully approach the Lord. And if the prayerful attitude is intensified, then we can chant the pure name. So in this way, gradually the focus comes from negative distraction to positive distraction to prayerful attitude and then to the Shuddha Naam. And the last one is about absorption in the holy name. That absorption is actually the fifth degree. First one is attraction, then attention, then attachment. Yeah, this is the way it gradually goes. First is attraction should be there. Some amount of attraction should be there. I will take the feedback and I will chant. And then we can gradually become attentive. And become very attentive. Then after that, that attentiveness gradually will, you know, bring us to the point of attachment. Attraction, attention, attachment. And then the fourth one is called absorption. When the attachment comes, if you very carefully see in your life, whatever you are attached to only, you know, that's where our mind gets absorbed. Absorption like a sponge dipped in water. Or ink pen kept on a blotting paper. It absorbs, isn't it? So absorption happens especially on days like Ekadashi Day when you chant many rounds. Continuously, non-stop, in an undistracted place with sincerity and seriousness and a humble attitude we chant. So then absorption will take place. And that leads to affection. The fifth A is affection. So attraction, attention, attachment, absorption and affection. So, somebody asked me, Spiritual Master, can you spell out the whole spiritual life in one word? He said, absorption, he said, in Krishna consciousness. Absorption, what is the meaning of absorption? We become oblivious to the outside world completely. Example is given in the 11th canto of Arrow Maker. He was sharpening the arrow. At the time, a king's procession went. Thousands of people passed by with big pomp, with band and instruments and many instruments and singing and singing and dancing, girls dancing, singers singing, and band players were playing band, and king went there, big chariot and lot of noisy thing. But this fellow who was making arrow, sharpening the arrow, he was so much absorbed in it. You know, he asked the people, really, I never saw it, he said. He just failed to notice it passing by. That was his absorption. Absorption means we forget our material upadhis. Sarva upadhi venir mukta. We don't think I'm a man or a woman. I am fair or black, I am rich or poor, you know, who am I? I don't even think. I only think I am Krishna Das now. I am servant, I am just chanting His holy name. That is actually called absorption. And then by that, losing the material identities is a very wonderful thing, because we feel our correct identity as Krishna Das, a Krishna Dasi, like that. So in this way, being grateful, patient, focused and absorbed in the holy name, we can actually make an effort to chant the holy name in Namabhas. Namabhas actually is a clearing stage. When we call out the holy name with sincerity, with seriousness, in a helpless attitude, free from offenses. So let us try to chant the holy name and purify our heart so that once we are purified, our service to Krishna, Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas will be much more purer and better, and it will really touch their hearts and benefit them. Thank you. Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Prabhu, now I can take 5 minutes questions.
Sure, Prabhuji. Thank you so very much for that insightful class.
Thank you.
In fact, I was making a sort of points and I could make around 31 points of the whole class. I have this habit of just sharing the take-home points after the session. So I'll do that after you take some questions. So I didn't see any questions on Facebook, but I had a question while you were talking. Prabhuji, in the beginning, you mentioned that holy name is very powerful, so much powerful that it can cleanse up more anarthas than one can ever commit.
Correct. That's so correct. That's
how to not take it in a loose way, or how to not misuse that statement, and how to like ensure that we focus on the holy name and not on the other way around? Like,
no, the reason why it is said like that, many times we fail to know the power of the holy name. We suspect the power of the holy name. Like one place Lord Chaitanya says in Chaitanya Lila, that don't think simply this chanting and dancing whether it can produce such a great transcendental result. Don't take it very cheaply, because the process appears very elementary and easy, but it is very, very profound. And therefore, in order to say the profundity of the process, therefore such kinds of shlokas are said. Actually, as you said, if somebody thinks that anyway, whole name has so much power to take away all my sins, I can commit the sins and the whole name will take care, then it comes under the seventh offense. Namno baladya sehi papa buddhihi na shuddhyate yamarghi shuddhihi. So that verse says that actually na vidyate yamarghi shuddhihi. It says that if somebody plans to abuse the holy name for, you know, clearing up his sins, then the holy name will become very upset with us. Just like, you know, sometimes you find a terrible disease overtakes the body uncontrollably. Like recently we saw some people dying out of corona. You know, uncontrollably the disease spreads in the body. Similarly, the holy name, if it becomes upset with us, it will become very distasteful. And so much, the degree we are more offensive, to that degree we will not be able to even utter the holy name. You know, even to say Rama, Valmiki could not utter the word Rama. That much it can become difficult for us. If you take the bead back, you will feel aversion. I can't chant. Therefore, the seventh offense is the worst type of offense, it is said. One should not take the holy name cheaply. One should not abuse it. It is like betraying a person who actually put faith in us. It's like saying, please give me 5 lakh rupees, I will return back in 5 days. And then you take 5 lakh rupees and run away. And he can never find you, who you are, where are you. It's like betraying a person, cheating a person. So one should not abuse the holy name. Real pastime comes about this. In Srimad Bhagavatam, actually Vritrasura was a big asura, he had to be killed. All the demigods went to Lord Vishnu, and then based on his guidance, they got the Vajra from the body of Dadichi Muni. After that, now who will kill that Vritrasura? He is a Mahabhagavata. You know, so Indra was also hesitant to kill Vritrasura. But at that time, all the demigods and sages, in a chorus, they told Indra, don't worry. Lord Narayana's name is very potent and powerful. If you kill Vritrasura now, after you kill him, we all are here for you. We will perform a very great sacrifice chanting Lord Narayana's name. We will chant Narayana Suktam and Sri Suktam, all that we will chant. And then you will be liberated from all the sinful reactions. Don't worry. One holy name is powerful to eradicate the sins, the sinful reactions which can fill up a whole universe, they said. One holy name is Eka Krishna Nam Sarva Papahaya Kshaya. Like that, there is a verse which says, you know. So they told, and putting faith in their words, Indra actually killed Vritrasura. After that, when he turned around, all the guys ran away. All of them, those who told him. There was no one around. So, and then Indra was chased by a very deadly witch, type of lady. She was blood and vomit was coming out of her mouth. She had tuberculosis. Like that, she was shouting and coming behind him. And he was going up in the sky, inside the water, inside the cave. Wherever he went, she was chasing after him. After going long, long, long distance, he got really tired. He went to the Manasarovar lake and he entered into a lotus and went deep down in the stem of the lotus where Goddess of Fortune, Lakshmi, mother of the universe, she resides. And he fell at her feet and said, oh, mother, mother, please save me, protect me. She said, don't go anywhere, just sit here. in my lotus feet and continuously perform penance for 1,000 years, she said. And in those 1,000 years, you know, Agni is the one who takes the sacrificial offerings to all the devatas. But Agni saw that this fellow is sitting inside the water. So he said, sorry, Indra, I cannot bring it inside the water because I will get extinguished. So 1,000 years he could not eat one, he didn't get any offering for eating. So why I told you this, seventh offense is terrible. And this is the kind of punishment one will get if one commits. All right, Prabhu.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji. That was a very apt explanation to why one should not misuse or abuse, as you rightly said, the holy name.
Yeah.
So, on behalf of the complete congregation of Singapore, we would like to really thank you from our heart for spending your time.
Thank you so very much. Actually, His Grace Devakirandan Prabhu had come to, you know, he had come to Pune online. He gave us a beautiful class some time ago. Our congregation is still talking about the class even months later. Remembering all of you are very blessed and fortunate in Singapore. In Singapore, you have Prabhuji available there and giving classes. And also, he's a very wonderful Vaishnava for teaching everybody by his example and how to deal with other Vaishnavas. And many devotees from different parts of the world have come to Singapore. I also have heard the glories of Singapore Yatra from Dinamandu Chaitanya Prabhu. He told me that he is making a video now currently of the whole project, what all you all do and everything. I told him I would love to have it so we can copy some of the things in our Pune Yatra also. So, please pass my thanks to Devakirandan Prabhu and all the senior devotees there. And thank you for giving me the chance to glorify the holy name and sanctify my heart a little more so that I will earn your blessings and chant the holy name myself perfectly. Talking is very easy, but it's easily... But the real chanting of the holy name is easily said than done. So, thank you.